Jesus say at the end of that gospel? He said, I am with you always. He was talking to his disciples who were building his church. He said, I'm with you always. So does that mean Jesus is here now?
Yeah.
You're right. He is here now. So good. Now, what is this question? Is that a crazy question? A world. It's a globe. Okay, it's a beach ball kind of thing. A globe on it. Does anybody, can you put it in the map? The earth, okay. Does anyone, anybody find us here in Preston? Can you find it? Okay, keep your finger right there, that's pretty good. All right, now I need somebody else. Okay, over here, keep your finger there. Over here, this is Spain. Okay. And I used to be a pastor just like right next to his finger. Here, city. But now, my wife and I are in Spain. I'm going to be a pastor in Spain, so I need to put your finger there in Spain. I need one more. Just one more. Okay. See if I can find a way over here. Can you read that word?
What?
You're here in Spain. It was Spain. Papua New Guinea. One of my friends that I went to a missionary class with is going to Papua New Guinea. You say that? Say Papua. Okay, don't say it. Now put your finger on Papua. Now, Jesus says, I am with you always. So is Jesus here in Preston? And when the Spaniards get together, is he in there? And is he in Papua New Guinea too?
Yeah.
Wow. You know, he's God. He's going to do what he's going to do. But he's told us how he does it. In fact, he said it in the Old Testament. He said, where my word goes, it does what I want to do. I'm with you always. And so, where Jesus' word is at, he's there. Okay, he says that he's there in Preston, he's there in Spain, he's there in Papua New Guinea, he's in all those places. Okay, you guys go sit down. He's anywhere where his word is at, and his word isn't just there, but he's doing things. Okay, it says, accomplish what I wanted to do. It's not my fault. And what is it? What is it? First and foremost, that God wants his word to do. Pastor talked about it already. But that thing that he wants his word to do is special. We do it at the start of the service. We confess our sins. We confess the things we've done wrong. But what does Jesus want his word most especially to do? What does Jesus do with your sins? Well, he's taken them from you already. Where did Jesus take your sins to? Well, he took them to the cross and left them there before he went back to heaven. But he takes your sins and he forgives you. He says, your sins are gone. That's what his word does. That's what he wants his word to do, whether you're in Spain, or whether you're in Montana, or whether more, no matter where you're at in the world, Jesus is coming to you with his word to forgive you. And you can be confident about that because he died and he rose again for that, to make that happen. Let's say a prayer about forgiveness. Dear Jesus, thank you for forgiving us. Thank you for going to the cross to win that forgiveness. And thank you for being with us to remind us every day, to tell us every day that we are forgiven, that in you we have life with you forever and ever. Thank you, and we pray this in your precious name.